Okay, so I'm gonna give you a quick review and a tutorial of the game, the PSVR game, SuperHyperCube, which in my opinion is a virtual reality game that is really good, that is, you know, quite surprising. I didn't expect it to be that good for me. I just tried it because it looked like a 3D Tetris, and it sort of reminded me of, or I thought that it was going to be like the super old school and ahead of time game that was called, I think, Blockout, which will be, it worked. I saw other people playing it because by then I was too young. I think I was like, I don't know, 2 or 3 years old, but the game looked pretty interesting. It was, even though, you know, it was back then, in like in 1990, a very long time ago, it was basically a 3D Tetris with a top view perspective. So you will see it from above. And Super Hypercube is very similar, but it's not the same thing. In my opinion, I even liked it more than Tetris Effect, which is the popular virtual reality game related to, you know, to the Tetris stuff and all that. But I actually liked Super Hypercube a lot more, because I think that it uses the medium in ways that I found more exciting and more innovative, in my opinion, because it puts you on the edge of the seat. Like, it really makes a, you know, it's a difficult game. It's a difficult puzzle game. It's very visual. It relies on speed on your part. At the beginning, obviously, it feels very challenging for everyone. Even for me, it felt extremely challenging at the beginning. But as you play it more and more, you get better at it, and you see yourself going farther and farther, and you get into later levels, you start to actually enjoy it a lot, and to have a lot of fun with it, and to, you see yourself engaged with it, like, not just thinking a lot, but you have to think fast. And it's a rush. It's a rush because you don't know how far you get in it. You're constantly on the verge of losing in the game. So, you know, seeing that you get farther in it to a later level, it's obviously because you got better in skill. It makes you feel really good. It's honestly one of those, I think they call them psychedelic, something like that, beer games, like Polybius. Polybius, it goes so fast that when you begin playing that, you're like, how are you even going to finish this? It seems impossible. But, you know, the more you play it, your reflexes start to go up, and what seemed really fast, you start to be able to see it. So you gain skills, basically, visual skills. You get better, you get faster, and you get to a point where you can do it. What, you know, like long time ago before when you began to play it, or when you saw it for the first time, it seemed impossible. I think Rocket Fury is a lot like that too. Like at the beginning, you begin playing and it seems easy, but when you get to the hard mode, which is a gold clash, I think. Yeah, gold clash. It seems impossible to beat those robots with the rackets. That ball, you can barely see the ball. But when you get better at it, you kind of get like in the zone, you know, like a psychedelic kind of thing. And then you go there and you finally beat the match, even though it seemed really difficult and seemed really fast. So Super Hypercube is a lot like that, but with similarities to Tetris. It's different. It's not the same thing, but it has similarities to it. And there's like speed involved. You have to go really, you have to think fast, because it has, by the way, I don't think this is a spoiler or anything like that, because the game is so difficult that I think this is actually a relief knowing this. It has 100 levels or 100 walls. So basically, if you manage to finish the 100 walls, you get to the end of Super Hypercube. But at the beginning, it is so difficult that, you know, when you begin playing, the first few times, it's almost certain that you're not gonna get to wall number 20 because of how difficult it is. And you just don't have the reflexes or the speed in your eyes, in your thinking, in your strategy to be able to get that far. So So yeah, review wise, I like it more than Tetris Effect, and I obviously I'm gonna be biased. I am right now. The other day I got the top scorer in the game for PSVR worldwide, globally, which is something that if you told me this a few months ago, I've had the game for a long time. You know, I bought it 1 year and a half ago, I think, very long time ago. So it's not something, you know, genius or something that you will go like, wow. But I know it's difficult. You know, I got there, so I know it's really difficult, even though I've had the game for a very long time. So obviously I'm a little biased. Obviously I enjoyed it. I liked it a lot, but I feel that a lot of people will love this game. Like I like it a lot more than Tetris Effect. And I felt that way about it when I was really bad at it, when I couldn't get past level 3 and 4 at the very beginning. I feel that way about it now, and I felt that way about it back then at the beginning. I think it's better than Tetris Effect because it gives you, you know, like a bigger mental rush. Like it's exciting when you see yourself passing the levels, even though you know that they are timing you and that you're against the clock and that you have to think and that it's difficult, it gives you a rush. It's really exciting to see yourself passing that. So, and I think it uses the VR, the virtual reality medium, really well. Because you see yourself there, you can see the, you know, the floating 4D walls and the floating cube, and it's a good experience. It's interesting. I think that even people that are not that much into puzzle games might enjoy it a lot because of not because it is a puzzle game, but because of the rush that the VR experience of playing that and passing the walls gives you. So, you know, I'm not gonna rate it or rank it like with grace or anything like that. Obviously, the other day I just got the number one score for the game in PSVR. So obviously I love it and I enjoyed it and I think it's great. And I mean, it's not necessarily a 10 out of 10, but I would definitely give it like no less than 9.5 out of 10 because I have really had some really good, moments of excitement with this SuperHyperCube puzzle game. It might be my favorite puzzle game of all time. It's not necessarily the best one. You know, there are others that are really good, like, just to name something else, Lost Vikings in the SNES. It's an old game, but it was really good. Sokoban on PC, that's super classic for puzzles. Obviously, Tetris, which has many forms. Even the super old 3D one that I mentioned at the beginning, the old school one, I think it was from DOS, MS-DOS, right? Block Out. But this one I liked even more, and it is in 4D. It's in virtual reality, so, you know, it looks a lot better. It's more exciting. It's a bigger rush. It's a better game in every way. So, review-wise, I highly recommend it. I think it is the number one puzzle game in PSVR. I think the reason why not too many people played it is that they priced it, they were selling it at $30 at the beginning, which I think is a lot. I mean, the game is good, but it's not like Skyrim, you know? It's a puzzle game. And right now they have it at $15, but it's like, right now it's like 4 years later. So they still have it at $15. It should be $9 or $10. Even 4 years later, but it's worth it. I got more than those $15 from all the time that I played it and all the excitement and rush that it gave me so many times. You know, trying to beat high scores, trying to get into the top 100, trying to get then into the top 20 and then into the top 10. And when I finally got there, I could barely believe it. And you know, the other day I got the number one score, so it's just crazy. So review wise, I say if you have PSVR, I will mark Super Hypercube as the most have puzzle game. Not because the guy that got the number one score is telling you, I'm that guy by the way. Not because of that, but because it's really a good experience. Like if you hear, I'm comparing it with Racket Fury. The Racket Fury, but for puzzles. I'm comparing it with Polybius in speed and racing. So the Polybius, but for puzzles. So if you think that Polybius and what was the other one that was really good? Thumper. That one was really good. I didn't finish that one. That I just didn't have patience for it, but it was great. It was great. If you like that, you should try SuperHyperCube. It's the same style of game, but in the puzzle genre. And it's very visual. Like, if you like the idea of improving, like, real life skills, like with Beat Saber, that, you know, if you play a little Beat Saber, your hand-eye coordination is gonna get better, like, for some sports as well. I think that the same with SuperHyperCube. You're gonna get better at visualizing shapes really fast, recognizing them, and you know, it's just a game that I recommend. It's really good. So that's my review for it. Now we're gonna go to the tutorial.